Hi, it's Fran with Little Windows. I've got four projects to show you using the medium and small bezels from LittleWindows.com. To make these, you'll need two sizes of bezel in the same shape, brilliant resin, and some glow-in-the-dark additive. Each project has some other supplies you'll need too. You'll also want a level of some kind to make sure your surface is nice and even. I'll be using our aqua glow additive and our green glow additive. This resin was made for jewelry making. It's super clear, low bubbling, and you can mix a tiny little batch and it'll still set up beautifully. Brilliant resin is the safest epoxy you'll find, and we're working in small batches in a well-ventilated space. Make sure you have fresh air in your workspace and wear gloves if you're sensitive or you think you might get it on your hands, or if you're making a lot of projects at once. First, I'll show you how to make this skull and spiders necklace. This uses one medium oval bezel and one small oval bezel. I have three little spider charms and a skull charm. The skull and the top two spiders came with rings on them. I just snipped those off. This project will be made in three layers. I've split a batch of resin and have mixed the green glow powder into a portion of that. I only need enough for a thin layer at the bottom of these bezels. I've mixed in quite a bit of the glow-in-the-dark additive because I'm only going to be pouring a very thin layer. That way it'll glow nicely. We're going to let that glow layer set up for about 6 hours. Then pour a layer of clear resin so that it's just below the top edge of the bezel. To add the smoky detail, I'll mix some black resin colorant into a little bit of resin and use a straight pin to create my smoke effects. I'll swish the black resin through the top clear layer. You can create any pattern you want. If you want a more distinct pattern, just let the resin set up for about an hour before you create your swishes. I've created these random patterns and noticed that the bottom, smaller piece has more black in it, so I want to match that in the top. I'm just going to add a little bit more here. Let the swishy layer set up for at least 6 hours. And then add another clear layer. You want to pour this layer so it's just above the edge of each bezel. Let this top clear layer set up for about an hour and a half to 2 hours. You want it to be nice and thick, like the resin in this cup, so that it'll hold its shape. I've already added my skull charm. It's still very sticky, so I can press this spider charm right into the resin. Set it where you want it to be and push it down into the resin. This is one of my favorite techniques. I call it the ripple effect. Let this set up 12 hours and you can assemble your jewelry. I'm using a natural black rubber cord for the necklace and jump rings to connect the bezels and the charm at the bottom. I love how the black resin colorant looks like smoke in this one, especially when it's glowing. This next project uses images printed on our clear photo film. I use the photo cropping software we offer at LittleWindows.com, which can resize and crop your photos onto a 4x6 or an 8.5x11 format. For this project, I used the 4x6 format and printed onto clear photo film. This is very high resolution photo film that will bond permanently to inkjet inks. And you'll see it's the perfect size to fit in these bezels. In the first layer for this piece, I added our glow-in-the-dark aqua. Then I poured a thin layer of resin so that it was level with the bezel and laid my cutout printed images on the top. Now I'll dome it up with another layer of clear resin. We developed brilliant resin for jewelry making so it casts and domes beautifully. Since our images are on the clear photo film, the bottom layer glows through beautifully. Look how this glows! Here's another idea you might want to try. I had a bunch of leftover watch parts, gears and hands and things. This piece also started with aqua glow additive in the bottom layer. Then I poured a clear layer, let that thicken up, and here I'm pressing the gears into that thickened resin. For the smaller bezel, I have this tiny little kitty cat. I thought that would be a fun compliment. So you can see the resin is thickened up quite a bit, but it's still very sticky. So I'm able to reposition this just the way I want. And here's how it turned out. I love the dimension on this one. I used a large gear to act kind of like a clock face, and I've positioned the hands at midnight. And I love how it looks when it's glowing and when it's not. And here's an idea using rub-on transfers and crystals. These are rub-on transfers. They're designs printed on a sheet that you can cut and use in lots of different ways. I've just cut out several elements and I'm going to collage them together. They work really well between layers of resin. I'll just press this along the side of the bezel to get my size and trim it to fit. You'll peel off the protective backer. The printed part is adhesive, so it'll stick to your surface, so don't touch it before you apply. Push it in place. This is probably easier with a stylus, but I couldn't find mine, so I'm just using a crochet needle. You can use any firm tool to rub down your transfers. When the image releases from the backer film and sticks to your piece, it turns a grayish color. If it still looks black, keep rubbing. The film has a waxy surface. That's what's coming off here. You just wipe that off. Peel off the backer sheet and get rid of any of those waxy crumbs. Just place these anywhere you'd like. The lighter color outlines around the designs will disappear in resin. These rub downs are somewhat delicate, and I've scratched a point off of one of these stars. Ugh, my nails look awful. I'll use them to scratch off this part of the transfer and replace that part of the design. There we go. Now we'll add a top layer that will protect the rub downs and make a beautiful shiny dome. Pull your resin to make sure it reaches the edge all around the bezels. Always cover your resin projects when you're not working on them. I'm going to let this layer set up for an hour and a half or 2 hours so that the resin thickens up. And then I can add some flat back crystals to my design. I'm using tiny pointy swabs to apply these. These are great and have so many uses. The tip is quite firm. Use these to position the crystals wherever you want. The top layer is somewhat firm, but very tacky, so I can easily position these. All of these bezels have two loops. These are great for connecting your jewelry and using as handles while you're working with resin. Lightly position the crystals on your piece. and then use the tiny pointy swab to push them down into your resin, creating that ripple effect. If these crystals or anything with facets sinks below the surface of the resin, the light can no longer reflect off of them, so they won't be sparkly, they'll look like a flatback mirror. If you touch the resin at this stage, it'll leave fingerprints. See what I mean by the ripple effect? It really enhances all your little details. Cover your projects, let them set up for a full 10 to 12 hours before handling, and then attach them together to make jewelry. On this one, I added a decorative bead at the bottom. You can attach the bezels with jump rings or wire, and added a ribbon that looks beautiful in the sun and also looks incredible when it glows in the dark. For close-ups of all these projects, more details on how to make them yourself, and supplies, come on over to littlewindows.com. For supplies and more project ideas, come to little-windows.com.